Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel for a new tutorial. Today we make this beautiful flower square. You need 5 different colors of yarn and also 1 black. I have to work with a 4mm crochet hook from my choice of yarn. You need also a scissors and a needle. Start with the first color. For me is that a bright pink. And we begin with a magic circle. And now we work in that magic circle 8 times a 2 double crochet together with between 1 chain stitch. Your first 2 double crochets together is a little bit different than the other 7. We start with a chain 2, 1, 2, and then make 1 double crochet in that magic circle. So yarn over, in the magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, and pull for 2. These 2 stitches are the first 2 double crochet together. Now make a chain 1. The repeat of this round, we make 7 times 2 double crochets together with between 1 chain. Yarn over, enter hook in the magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull for 2. Yarn over, back in that same magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2. Now you have 3 loops on the hook, we work all these stitches together. Yarn over and pull through in 1 go. And then make 1 chain. We do this 6 more times. So in the magic circle, 2 double crochets together. That's 1. And 2. 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over, work all these stitches together and then make a chain. 1. 2 double crochets together in the magic circle. And a chain 1. I have here 4 groups of 2 double crochets together with between a chain 1. We have to work 8 in total. I have to work 1 more time the last repeat, 2 double crochets together and then a chain 1 on the end. I have here 8 times 2 double crochets together with between chain 1. Now we pull on that short tail to close the magic circle. And now here on top of the very first 2 double crochets together, and that's on the top of the very first double crochet after that chain 2, you go under through that V on the top and make 1 slip stitch. Make 1 chain to make a little knot. Cut the yarn. And then you can weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. Second color, that's for me in light pink. Make a slip knot on the hook. And then we begin in a chain 1 space with a standing puff stitch of 4 loops. So the yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter hook in a chain 1 space, grab your yarn, pull up, and then pull your hook a little bit higher, like this. Then yarn over, enter hook in that same stitch, grab your yarn and pull up a little bit higher, that's 2. Yarn over, in that same stitch, of in that same space, grab your yarn, pull up. Yarn over, in that same chain 1 space, grab your yarn and pull up. Now we have here all these loops, we work all these stitches together. Yarn over and pull through all the loops in 1 go and then make 1 chain to close that puff stitch here on the top. This is your very first puff stitch. Now back in that same chain one space, we make another puff stitch of four loops. Yarn over, in that chain one space, grab your yarn and pull up a little bit higher. That's one, yarn over, two, yarn over, three, and four times. We work all these loops together, yarn over and pull through all the loops in one go, and then make one chain. These two puff stitches, we work that all the way around 8 times in total, but in the next chain one space we make not that standing puff stitch. We work a puff stitch here in that next chain one space. So the next repeat, 4 loops, a puff stitch. So make a little bit higher. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Work all these loops together and close with a chain. Back in that same chain one space, another puff stitch. 1, 2, 3, and 4. We work all these loops together, yarn over, pull through in one go and make one chain. The second repeat is done. You have to repeat 6 more times all the way around, and I'll see you here in the beginning. I'm all the way around, 8 times 2 puff stitches, 16 in total. On the end we close here on top also with a chain 1. Now on the top of the very first puff stitch, make 1 slip stitch. To close this round, make 1 chain to create a little knot, cut the yarn and weave the tails in. Next color, it's apricot color for me, and make a slip knot on the hook. And then we start between 2 puff stitches that we work in that same chain one space. Between those 2 stitches, here in that space, we begin with a standing double crochet. Yarn is on the hook, then you yarn over, enter your hook between the 2 puff stitches, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. This is a standing double crochet. You make 4 double crochets in that same space. More, so yarn over, enter your hook in that same space, grab your yarn, pull up and make a second double crochet. 5 in total, all in that same space. That's 3, 4, and 5. So you have here 5 double crochets all in that same space between the 2 puff stitches. Then make 1 chain, and this is the repeat you work 7 more times all the way around. So you skip now here that next puff stitch, also the next puff stitch, and then between the 2 next puff stitches that you work in the next chain one space, you work again 5 double crochets all in that same space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you make 1 chain. I'll show you the repeat one more time. So the next repeat, you work between the next 2 puff stitches that you make in that same chain one space, 5 double crochets in that space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then chain 1. Work like this all the way around 8 of these groups of 5 double crochets with between a chain one all the way around. I'm all the way around. After that last group of 5 double crochet, you have to work also one chain. On top of the very first standing double crochet, you work one slip stitch. Make one chain, cut the yarn and weave both tails in. Now we have to work with a black color. Make a slip knot on the hook. And then we start here in a group of 5 double crochets on top of the second double crochet with a standing single crochet. The yarn is on the hook. Now enter the hook in the second double crochet. So 1, 2 here on the top. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull for 2 for a standing single crochet. Also in the next 2 stitches, 1 single crochet. That's 1. And in the next 2. So we have here 3 single crochets. Make a chain 1. And now you work a puff stitch between the 2 puff stitches here under. Under that chain 1. Here between the 2 puff stitches. Yarn over, you go around that chain 1 here, and then here between the 2 puff stitches here under, make a puff stitch of 4 loops. So grab your yarn and pull up and bring it on the same level than the single crochets here. That's 1. 2, 3, and 4. Now yarn over and pull through all the loops in 1 go. And then make 1 chain to close the puff stitch here. And this is the repeat you worked 7 more times all the way around. I'll show you one more time. So you skip here the first double crochet of that 5 and then on top of the second double crochet make 1 single crochet. And that's the first of 3. So 1 into the next stitch, single crochet, 2 and in the next stitch also 1 single crochet. That's 3. Now make a chain. Then you have here a chain 1 and then here under between the puff stitches make a new puff stitch of 4 loops at the same level of that single crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yarn over, work all these loops together and then make 1 chain all the way around 8 times in total. I'm all the way around. Close the puff stitch here with a chain 1. Then on top of the very first standing single crochet, make a slip stitch. 1 chain to make a little knot. Cut the yarn and weave the tails in on the back of the stitches. Next round with a next color, that's a darker peach from Mai. And then we make a slip knot on the hook. And we start with a standing single crochet on top of the second single crochet of those 3 here. It's 1 and 2 in that stitch. Standing single crochet, the yarn is on the hook. Enter your hook in the second single crochet. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2. Now make a chain. And now here on top of the puff stitch, you make one double crochet on top of that stitch. Then a chain one, back on top of that same stitch, double crochet in that same stitch, chain one, and also one double crochet back in that same stitch. So you have here on top of the puff stitch, double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, double crochet. Now make one chain. And then we start all over with the first stitch here on top of the three single crochets in the second single crochet. So one and two in that second single crochet, we start all over again with one single crochet, chain one, then on top of the next puff stitch we make one double crochet, chain one, double crochet in that same stitch, chain one, and a double crochet back in that same stitch, and then make one chain. The second repeat is complete. You have to work six more times all the way around. On top of here, the very first standing single crochet, you make one slip stitch, one chain to create a little knot, cut the yarn and weave the tails in. I start with a light green in the next round. Make a slip knot on the hook. And then I start with a standing single crochet in the chain one space for that stitch here, that single crochet here in the middle. So we have here chain one, single crochet, chain one. In that first chain one, standing single crochet in that space. And then we make a front post single crochet around the single crochet here. So we enter the hook here in that chain one, go around that single crochet, grab your yarn and pull under through that stitch, yarn over and pull through two. Now here in the next chain one space, make also one single crochet. Single crochet, front post single crochet and a single crochet. Now we make again puff stitches. Here in that next chain one space between the next two double crochets, make one puff stitch of four loops. So yarn over, enter your hook here in that chain one, grab your yarn and pull a little bit up. That's one, two, three, and four. Yarn over and work all these stitches together and close with a chain. Now make a chain one. Back in that same chain one space, make one more puff stitch of four loops. One, two, three, and four. Yarn over and pull through all the loops in one go and make one chain. So like this, make a chain one. Now we skip over here to the next chain one space and we make again a puff stitch of four loops. Close with a chain, then make a chain one. Back in that same space, another puff stitch of four loops. Close with a chain on top of that puff stitch. And then we start all over again with the first single crochet here. So your first repeat is complete. I'll show you one more time. Here, that next repeat, in that chain one space, make one single crochet. Around that single crochet, a front post single crochet. So go around that stitch. In the next chain one space, one single crochet. And then here in the next chain one space, make one puff stitch, four loops. Work all the stitches together, close with a chain. Make a chain one, back in that same chain one space with another puff stitch. Close with a chain. Make a chain one. In the next chain one space, a puff stitch. Close with a chain, chain one, puff stitch into the same space, and close with a chain. Work like this all the way around. Repeat six more times and start here with a single crochet in the next chain one space. Front post single crochet around the single crochet, in the next chain one space also one single crochet, and then make your puff stitches. We close here on top of the very first standing single crochet with a slip stitch, cut the yarn and weave the tails in. We start on the last round, final round of this flower, with the same peach color of round 3. That goes back on the hook with a slip knot. And then we start here in those 3 single crochets, that single crochet, front post single crochet and that single crochet. Here, for that single crochet after that puff stitch in that chain one space, of in that space, that's not a chain one space, that's a little space here. We start with a standing single crochet between those 2 stitches. So between the puff stitch and the single crochet. Now here on top of the front post single crochet, make one single crochet on top of that stitch, and then after that single crochet and for the puff stitch here in that space between the 2 stitches, work also one single crochet. Then make a chain one, and then here between the next 2 puff stitches in that chain one space, we make 4 double crochets in total. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then here in the next chain one space, between the next 2 puff stitches, we make 2 trebles. For a treble, yarn twice over the hook, and the hook in that chain one space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull to 2, yarn over, pull to 2, yarn over, pull to 2. Again, back in that same space, a treble. So yarn over, pull to 2, yarn over, pull to 2, yarn over, pull to 2. Then we make a picot of 3 chain stitches, 1, 2, 3, and then on top of the second treble stitch, you work here under through that V-stitch on the top, and that little stitch next to it. So you have here 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull to 3 in one go for a picot. Back in that same last chain 1 space, make 2 more treble stitches in that space. So 1, yarn twice over, and 2. Now between the next 2 puff stitches in that chain 1 space, make 4 double crochets all in that same space. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then make 1 chain. And all these stitches is to repeat your work 7 more times all the way around. I'll show you the repeat one more time. So we start here after that puff stitch and 4 that single crochet in that space between those stitches with a single crochet. Then on top of the front post single crochet, 1 single crochet. And then after that single crochet and for the puff stitch, between those 2 stitches, make 1 single crochet. Make a chain 1, then between the next 2 puff stitches, 4 double crochets in that chain 1 space. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then skip over the next puff stitch, between the next 2 puff stitches in that chain 1 space, make 2 trebles. That's 1 and 2. Now we make a little picot. 1, 2, 3 chains on top of the last stitch, under to that V and that little stitch next. Grab your yarn and pull to 3 in one go. 2 trebles in the same space. 1 and 2. Then skip over the next chain 1 space, between the next 2 puff stitches, make 4 double crochets in that space. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then make 1 chain. Don't forget that chain here on the end and in the beginning. And then you start all over again. Repeat those stitches 6 more times. Close with an invisible join. Make all your stitches and I'll show you how to make that invisible join here in the beginning. I'm all the way around. Don't forget to make that chain 1 after that last group of 4 double crochets here in that last space. So chain 1. Now cut the yarn and open up that last stitch. Then I grab the needle, make an invisible join in the beginning, and we have always to skip that first stitch. And we close with an invisible join, and that's the standing single crochet. You go to the next stitch, you go under to that whole V stitch of that single crochet on top. Then pull through. Then you go back to the last stitch and that's the chain 1. All in the back loop and also in the back loop of that standing single crochet. Then you pull through and this one here, that V stitch, is your invisible join. Now turn your work upside down and make a little knot on the back. And then you weave the tail in the back of the stitches. Do that also with the other tail. The flower is complete. Let's get started on the square. Black is back on the hook with a slip knot and we begin with a standing single crochet, back post single crochet around the front post single crochet here of that light green color. So we have here one single crochet, front post single crochet and a single crochet, and around that middle single crochet, that front post single crochet, that's the place where we make a back post single crochet. The yarn is on the hook. Now you enter your hook here between the single crochet and the front post single crochet. Then you work around that front post single crochet. Then you go back to the back of your flower. Then you grab your working tail, work under through, yarn over and pull for two. Now you see here on the front a little black stitch. Now we make the first loop of a chain six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Make those chain stitches not too tight. Now you go around that first flower petal. Then here, you have also that front post single crochet. You work around that stitch with a back post single crochet. Around that stitch, here on the back, grab your working tail, pull under through, yarn over and pull through two. This is your first loop here on the back. We have to work 8 loops in total. So the next loop is a chain 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. You work around the back of that next flower petal and then make a back post single crochet around the next front post single crochet. You're on the back. Make a chain 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 around the next flower petal and then a back post single crochet around the next front post single crochet. All the way around, 8 loops in total. Now we have here 3 loops. Work like this all the way around and I see you back here in the beginning. I make loops all the way around, make my last chain 6 here, and then we close here on top of the very first standing single crochet with a slip stitch. So here is our first standing back post single crochet. Enter hook in the top of that stitch, grab your working tail, pull through and pull through. Now we have all the way around 8 loops in total. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. In the next round you start with a slip stitch in the very first chain 6 space. Enter hook in that space, grab your working tail, pull up and pull through. Now make a chain 3, 1, 2 and 3. Counts for your very first double crochet. Now here in that chain 6 space make 5 double crochets. It's 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. With your very first chain 3 here, counts for your first double crochet. We have here 6 double crochets in that first chain 6 space. Now here in the single crochet stitch, we make a corner. 3 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochet, all in that same stitch. So in that top of that back post single crochet, 3 double crochets in that stitch, 1, 2, 3, make a chain 2, then you go back in that same stitch with another 3 double crochet. One, two, and three. This is your first corner. Now we begin on a straight side. In the next chain 6 space, make 6 double crochets. So one, two, three, four, 5 and 6, and we make also 6 double crochets into the next chain 6 space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now we work again a corner into the next back post single crochet. 3 double crochets in that stitch. 1, 2, and 3. Make a chain 2. 3 more double crochets back in that same stitch. 1, 2, and 3. 6 double crochets in the next chain 6 space. And also 6 double crochets in the next chain 6 space. Then in the next single crochet, make a new corner of 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet, all in that same stitch. Then we make in the next 2 loops of 6 chain stitches, 6 double crochet, in the next space 6 double crochet, then in the next stitch, new corner of 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet, and then in the last space also 6 double crochets in that chain 6 space, and then we close on top of the very first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch with a slip stitch. I work my stitches all the way around and you see here the start of the square. We have 2 times a group of 6 double crochets, then a corner, 6 double crochets, 6 double crochets and a corner, and 2 times 6 double crochets. Close on top of the very first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch with a slip stitch, 1, 2 and 3. In that stitch, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through. With the same color, we start with a chain 3, counts for a double crochet, and this is the last double crochet. Then we work all the way around, and then here in that space here, we have to work 2 more double crochets before we close that with a slip stitch to complete a group of 3 double crochets. So this here is your last double crochet of this round. Now we skip the next 3 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, and then here. So we have your 3 double crochets, and then here between the 2 stitches, make a new group of 3 double crochet. Not here in the top of that stitch, but between the stitches. 3 double crochets between those 2 stitches. For a group of 3 double crochet. Then you skip also 3 double crochets. Then between the next 2 stitches, also a new group of 3 double crochet. 1, 2, and 3. Then we skip 3 double crochets. Then here in the corner chain to corner space, we make a new corner. 3 double crochets in the chain 2 space. It's 1, 2, and 3. Make a chain 2. Back in that same chain to corner space with another 3 double crochet. 1, 2, and 3. And this is the way how we work all the way around. So we skip the next 3 double crochets between the next 2 double crochet. Make a new group of 3 double crochet in that space between those 2 stitches. Then skip the next 3 double crochets between the next 2 stitches. 3 double crochets between those stitches. And again, skip the next 3 stitches between the next 2. A new group of 3 double crochet. And again. So we work to the next corner. And again, 3 double crochet. You skip every time 3 double crochets to make a new group of 3 double crochet. Then here in the chain 2 corner space, make a new corner of 3 double crochet. Chain 2, 3 double crochet back in that same space. So like this. This is the way how you work all the way around. Work like this, all your stitches, and then close here on top with the very first double crochet, that's the last double crochet, with a slip stitch. But work all your stitches all the way around, and I'll show you how to make that last group of 3 double crochet. I'm all the way around. I have to create my last group of 3 double crochet here in the beginning, where we start with the chain 3. For that chain 3, here in that last space here, we work 2 more double crochets. That's 1, 2, and then your third is the chain 3. On top of that chain 3, in the third chain stitch, we make a slip stitch. So you have here also 1 group of 3 double crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round, we use the same color. We start with a chain 3, 1, 2, 3, counts for your first, very first double crochet. Now here in that space here under, we make the group complete of 2 double crochets. So we have here also in the beginning a group of 3 double crochet. We skip the next 3 double crochets, and then in the next space we make 3 double crochets. But we attach in the second double crochet that flower petal here. Yarn over and to hook in the next space between the next two groups of three double crochet, make one double crochet, then yarn over and to hook in the same space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through two. Now you have here that picot on the top of that flower petal. Enter your hook here in the top of the flower petal, grab your yarn, pull through three loops in one go, like this. And then you enter your hook here back into that same space with another double crochet to work that group of three double crochet also complete here on the back. Then you make three double crochets into the next space. One, two, and three. Then make a corner in the chain two corner space with three double crochet. Chain two. Three double crochets back in that same space. Then in the next space also three double crochet. And then in the next space we attach again a flower petal. Double crochet in the next space. Then yarn over and to hook in that same space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two. Then here on top of that picot, you go into that picot in the middle of that chain three, grab your yarn and pull through three in one go. Then back into that same space, make one more double crochet. In the next space, three double crochets in that space. And then in the next space, also three double crochets. We attach that flower petal into the next space. One double crochet in that space, then yarn over, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, attach that picot, yarn over and pull through three. Make one more double crochet in that same space. Three double crochet into the next space. And then you make a corner in that chain to corner space. This is the way how you work all the way around. And you see here that in a straight side between the two flower petals, we work two more times of two times a group of three double crochet. Hope that you can see here. Three double crochet, three double crochet. And then here, attach that flower petal. Then we have to work here one group of three double crochet for the corner. And that's after the corner. And then here, three double crochet for the corner. This is the way how you work all the way around. Make all your stitches and close on top here of the very first double crochet. That's the chain three in the third chain stitch with a slip stitch. I'm all the way around, close with a slip stitch on top of the very first chain three. We have to make one more round and then the square is complete. We start with a chain three in this last round, and this chain three counts for your last double crochet. If we work all the way around, we have to make here in that last space two more double crochets to make that last group of 3 double crochets complete. Now we skip over the next 3 double crochets, and then here in the next space make a new group of 3 double crochet. And now you work at the same way that you did before. In every space you make 3 double crochets, and in every corner you make a new corner of 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet all the way around. And then I let you see here how to make that last group of 3 double crochet. So if you work all the stitches all the way around, we have to create our last 3 double crochet group complete. Here this is your 3 chain stitches, and here for that chain 3 we make 2 double crochets in that last space. And then we close on top of the very first chain 3 with a invisible join. We cut the yarn, open up that last stitch, then I grab the needle, then we skip our first stitch, that's the first double crochet, that's the chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and then in the next stitch, that's on top of the very first double crochet of that group of 3, you go under to that V stitch, pull through, go back to the last stitch only in the back loop, and only in the back loop of that chain 3 top here in the third chain stitch, and then pull through, wave the tail in on the back of the stitches, and then the square is complete. I wave the tails in, and this is the end result. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!